This episode of Real Engineering is brought to you by Hover. Get 10% off your next domain purchase using the code REALENGINEERING. In 2007, Steve Jobs introduced the original iPhone, one of the most innovative and revolutionary products of the 21st century, ushering in a new era of smartphones and waiting in line to get one. The furore over this new phone was due in large part to the LCD multi-touch panel that allowed you to see and interact with the device with a clarity and mobility never seen before. Apple wasn't the first to introduce touch panel LCDs into phones, but they were the first to make people care about it. They revolutionized what was once a clunky and frustrating technology to one that could be easily used for typing on screen and gesture control. The screen itself featured a 3.5-inch diagonal 320x480 resolution LCD. Major shifts in iPhone usability and design over the years have been around the display. From the iPhone to the iPhone 3GS, the phones had a display density of 163 pixels per inch. The iPhone 4 Retina display doubled that to 326 ppi. This pixel size remained constant for another 7 years, while generational progress was made in LCD technology. More consistent backlighting, consistent color and brightness when viewing off angle, and a wider color gamut gave the new iPhone 8 the gold standard LCD panel. But for the iPhone 10, Apple has taken a sudden departure from its fateful LCD screens and jumping in bed with their arch rival, Samsung, who are manufacturing its new Oled display. The Apple Watch used OLED, but Samsung has been utilizing and maturing OLED technology for years in their Galaxy smartphones. This is the first time most Apple enthusiasts will experience OLED technology. So what are the fundamental differences between LCD and OLED? LCD stands for liquid crystal display. The liquid crystals used fall somewhere between a liquid and a solid, which allows them to change their molecular orientation when an electrical current is applied. This is incredibly useful as it allows us to use the molecules to manipulate light that is passing through the liquid crystal. Liquid crystal pixels do not produce their own light, but in modern LCD panels, LED backlighting is used with a backlight uniformity filter added to ensure even lighting across the panel. Next, the light passes through a polarization film, which only lets light traveling in the horizontal orientation to pass through, followed by the liquid crystal group, and then another polarizing filter orientated 90 degrees to the first. If you're familiar with polarizing filters, you will know that light cannot pass through two filters when they're aligned perpendicular to each other. So light depends on this liquid crystal layer to orientate the light to allow it to pass through the second filter. The liquid crystal layer is sandwiched between two electrodes and two pieces of etched glass, forcing the liquid crystal molecules into a near predictable 90 degree twist. When a voltage is applied through the electrodes, the crystal molecules begin to realign in the direction of the current. A larger voltage will result in a full 90 degree twist. As light passes through, it will follow the direction of the crystal molecules before encountering the second polarization filter. So the liquid crystal layer essentially acts as a controllable light valve. If light is allowed to pass, it will travel through a colored filter, giving it one of three colors, red, blue, or green. This structure is called a subpixel. Combine three subpixels with red, green, and blue filters, and you have a single traditional RGB liquid crystal pixel. This brings up a few really interesting characteristics of LCDs. The first is that even when the panel is displaying a black image, the backlight is always on, causing a large battery drain and some light leakage at pixel boundaries and at the edges of the screen, which negatively affects the screen contrast ratio. With the iPhone X, Apple engineers have adopted a fundamentally new display technology, OLED, or organic light emitting diodes. Samsung have a near-perfect monopoly on the manufacturing market for these screens, manufacturing 90% of the world's supply and holding the majority of the world's patents, forcing competitors like Apple to purchase from them to remain up to date with the best technology on the market, although it hasn't stopped them from reportedly investing billions in Samsung's major competitor, LG Display. OLED works very differently from LCD in a few key ways. For starters, there's no backlight. Instead, each pixel is self-illuminating through the light-emitting process called electrophosphorescence. There are two organic compounds called the emissive and conductive layers that are sandwiched between an anode and a cathode. As an electrical current flows from the cathode to the anode, electrons are given to the emissive layer and removed from the conductive layer. The electrons in the emissive layer now migrate to fill the holes in the conductive layer. When they do, extra energy is released as a photon. This entire process is controlled and structured by the TFT matrix, and the entire structure is placed on a substrate of either glass or polymer. Since there is no backlight and each individual pixel is individually controlled, substantial power saving can occur when displaying dark or black images. In addition, OLED panels are significantly thinner and lighter than their LCD counterparts, allowing for slimmer devices with razor-sharp bezels and flexible screens like the one in the Samsung Galaxy S8. Lastly, OLED panels have high brightness and true 0 pixel values, leading to insane contrast ratios of over 1 million to 1. Blacks are inky, colors are more vibrant, and localized brightness can be greatly improved. There are some growing pains with OLED technology, holding it back in the mainstream consumer market. The chief limiting factor is burn-in. Burn-in occurs when the organic layers of the pixel begin to break down from prolonged usage. As the layers decay, they become significantly less bright than the pixels around them, which can make stationary UI elements appear as ghost images. This mainly occurs from prolonged static images, such as user interface icons, and is the single largest reason OLED computer monitors or TVs are not yet mainstream, not to mention the cost, which can be 1.5 to 2 times higher than an equivalent LCD panel. OLED has fundamental strengths over LCD that will open up possibilities for how and where displays are used in the world around us. LG Display has a consumer OLED television that is only 2.57 millimeters thick. They are working on transparent OLEDs that can be integrated into glass panels, and various OLED manufacturers are working towards foldable displays. With continued improvement, OLED displays look set to revolutionize the way we consume and view information in the world around us. Websites on your phone will look better than ever, but what's a good website without a great domain name? Hover is the easiest and best place to register a custom domain or email. You can even purchase domains right from your iPhone using Apple Pay. They have over 400 domain extensions and the best customer service in the business. Seriously, they've won awards. I couldn't believe my luck when I saw that the real.engineering domain was available on Hover and purchased it immediately, and it took less than 20 seconds to make it mine. I now have a custom email address that couldn't suit my channel better. If you're looking for a unique domain name, Hover is the best place to get one, and you can get 10% off your next purchase using the code REALENGINEERING. You could get the real.investments domain and use it for your online investment training site. Or you could get the real.security domain name for your cybersecurity blog. Whatever domain you want, you will probably be able to find one that suits your needs at Hover. And once again, you can get 10% off your next purchase using the code REALENGINEERING. As always, thanks for watching, and thank you to all my Patreon supporters. If you'd like to see more from me, the links for my social media accounts are in the description.